Assalamu alaikum, grade one, and good afternoon to all of you. How are you all doing? Great. That's very good. Yes, I'm also good. Alhamdulillah. Thank you. And welcome to your social studies class. Today, we will be taking the first lesson of week number 10, right? Okay. So far, in all of the previous 9 weeks, we have covered a lot of topics which were related to society, right? That what are different things in our society? How do we tackle with them? We started with a very basic learning of what society is. Then we started with the basic parts or units of society, let's say who you are, right? Intro to myself. Then we talked about the family, friends, and et cetera, right? Then we also talked about we talked about the healthy food, the healthy things that we are supposed to eat, how we can keep ourselves neat and clean, what are different jobs in our surroundings, right? Then we talked about that in the citizenship chapter, we started with our flag, right? And then we discussed what does flag means, how many colors it have, what does it represents, why do we love our flag? And there were a lot of things that we discussed, right? Okay. Then in the next class, we talked about our great leader, that is Qaed Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And then in the last week, we discussed the things in which for which we are proud of in Pakistan, right? So in all of that things, there were different some of the places, then some of the personalities, some of the things for which we are some. We discussed some of them only. There are a huge number of things for which we are proud of in Pakistan, but we started with the national anthem, then we talked about Dr. Abdul Salam, then we talked about the different places like Faisal Mosque. We have Shahi Killa, then we have Mazar-e-Qaid, right? So there were a lot of things that we discussed. Now, in today's class, we will be discussing another thing which is very, very important, and that is a basic part of your life. So first, I'll introduce you with the topic, and then we will also discuss that why we are studying this topic, right? Okay. So I'm going to share the screen, and you will be, I'll be showing you the pictures, and then you will guess the topic of today, okay? So show me a thumbs up if it is visible to you or not. Is it visible? Okay, great. What is this on your screen? It's a lunchbox. Great. Okay. And what do we do? What is the purpose of this lunchbox? We use it for saving our lunch, for saving our food, basically, right? And what do? We save our lunch in it, and then we so that we can eat it when we need it, right? When let's say you have a lunchbox when you go to the school, or let's say you are going for you are going to a park, okay, in the evening. You have a family your family plan to visit a park, and then your mother cooks some delicious food, and then she packed it in a lunchbox, and so that the kids, when they were playing in the park and they feel hungry, so she can take that stored food out of the lunchbox and you can eat it, right? So what is the purpose of lunchbox, basically? That we store food in it for the later purposes, right? Okay. Now I'm going to share the next picture with you, and you are supposed to identify that what it is, okay? Now tell me, what is this? These are money boxes. Excellent. Clap for all of you. Okay. Now what is money boxes? What is the purpose of money box? Like in the lunch box, we store lunch for later purposes. In money box, we store money for later purposes. Got it? So what is the purpose of money box? That in the money box, we keep on saving money. We put all the extra money, or the money which is not in our use right now, we put that in this. And then later on, so let's say if you see all of you, okay, raise your hands. How many of you have money box? Okay, great. So all of you have this habit of saving money. That's really very great. Amazing. Okay. So what to basically do? That somebody gives you money, right? And you are not needing it right now, right? So you will put it in that. And then one day, let's say you want to buy a football for you, or a girl wants to buy a doll, like you went to the market with your mother, and there you find a very beautiful doll and you want to buy it. So what you can do, that you can take the money out of your money box and you can buy the doll for yourself. right? And let's say in one of your sibling have a birthday and you want to give him the present, right? You want to decorate the room, you want to bring the cake, you want to bring the balloons and all that, right? So what you will be doing, you will be taking the mini out of your money box and you will decorate the room, you will arrange a birthday party for that, right? So this money which you are saving in this money box can be used in later on, or can be used for later purposes. So what is the role of, or what is the purpose of this box? Saving money, right? So the word money box, money, yes, and box mean the box in which we save it, right? It can be anything. Now there are some special boxes which are sold in the market as well, and you can make a small money box for you by yourself as well, right? We will learn that how we can make a money box. We will make a money box for ourselves in the class as well, right? I'll be telling you what is the material you will be needing for that, and then we will together make a money box for ourselves, right? Okay, so these are some beautiful money boxes that you can find in the markets. There is this Hello Kitty box, then we have this Foggy box, then we have the Doraemon box, and these are all of the basically these boxes are made according to the favorite characters of the cartoons, right? Or some famous character, cartoon characters, so that kids like these, and then they save money in it as well, right? Okay. So we have learned that these are money boxes, and how genius class I have that you just recognize it within the second that it's a money box, and what is the purpose of it, that we save money in it, right? Okay class, so the today's topic that we will be discussing is money box. What is a money box? The box in which we save money. Why I started the topic with this, because I want you to first learn about the importance of saving money. And now why we are starting this topic, because you know, at this even small age, if you have this habit that you keep on saving money, this is really very great. You know, when you, inshallah, when you will be grown up, you will be starting a job, and you will be, you know, you will have a family and a lot of things, right? So if you will not be having this habit, you can find a lot of troubles for that. So if you will be having this habit from the very beginning that we are supposed to save money, we are supposed to spend the money on the purposes or on the occasions where it is needed, right? Or we should not spend money for useless things. Let's say, consider this. Let's say you have already one school bag, right? And you have already school bottle as well, but still you went to a market and you ask your mother to, please can I have another school bag, and she says that kid, you already have a school bag, right? So when it will be torn, I'll buy a new one for you. But you just say no, I want the school bag. So that would be a useless thing for you at that moment, right? What you can do, you can keep the, or you can save the money of that school bag with you for the later purposes, and you can buy something useful at that time. Or let's say your school shoes are now, they're torn, right? You are needing one more school shoes. So what you can do, that you can buy that school shoes with that money, and you can carry on with the previous school bag, right? So instead of, why this topic is important, that through this topic we will learn that what is the right way, what is the right manner of spending money, where we should and where we should not spend money, and what are the benefits of saving money, right? So we will be learning this stepwise, right? Okay, now I'm going to share the screen again with you, and I'll be showing you. Okay, so tell me, what is this? Different notes, right? So is this Pakistani currency? Yes, this is. And how did you come to know about this, that this is Pakistani currency? Because it have the Qaed Azam's photo on it. Excellent. Okay, tell me, how many of you go to grocery with your mother? Yes, raise your hands. Very few. Okay, so some of you who went to the grocery, what are the things you observed there? let's say your mother she went to the grocery, she's in a store and she takes 3 to 4 things, right? So what does she do when she put the things on the counter? Does she give anything from herself? Like she wants, let's say she wants the flour and she wants a packet, she buy a packet of rice and an oil, 3 things, right? So does she give the ring of her ring on from her hand in as an exchange? She says that, please take my ring and give me this thing. Does this happen? No. What does she do for that, for the things? Money, right? So what we can say, or in order to learn this in a simplest way, is that money is basically exchange of things. We take one thing from the other, and as a result of that, we give money to them, right? And all of these notes which are in front of you, they have specific values. Let's say we have a 20 rupees note, then we have a 50 rupees note, 100, 500, 1000, and every note have a particular value to it, right? And you know this, that when you have this note, how many things you can buy with it, or what is the value of this thing, or how much grocery you can do with that, right? So when your mother, when your parents, they go to a store and they want to buy something, so they do take their money with them, right? According to their need. She knows that she will be needing this much thing, so she take money according to that, right? So what is money basically? It is a way of exchanging of things. We give money to buy other things, right? Okay. Now, I want all of you to open your book, page number 30. This is page number 30. I want you to open this. Let's do the reading of this. Babur says, I have saved rupees 25 in my money box, but I have a problem. He wants to buy these toys. Okay, the first one is these are blocks and these are of rupees 50, and then we have cars and these are of rupees 30, right? And he has only 25 rupees. So what he sees that these toys cost more than I have saved. What should I do now? Oh, I can wait and save more money, then I can buy the toys I want. See, he was Babar is a very good kid, and he saved money in the money box. And see, he has made a money box for himself. This is a cute money box, right? And he wants to buy something, a toy for him, but the toys are, yes, the prices of toys are higher than what he has saved. So what he, the solution that he find for himself is that he can wait for a moment and then he can buy the toys later on when he has more money. The money used in a country. Okay, so we will be reading just only till this, because the topic that we are covering today is this much. The rest of the topics we will be covering in the later classes. Okay, so now, tell me the question that I want to ask you before ending the class is, what do you do with the money you save for yourself? Where do you spend that money? Yes. The money that you save in your money box, where do you spend that money? Yes. Raise your hands and tell me one by one. Yes. Okay. Okay, so listen, as see class, Ahmed loves to collect different types of colors, right? Because Ahmed loves painting. So he buy different colors for himself, like crayons, pencil colors, marker colors, right? Okay, that's great. Superb. Okay, who is going to share the next? Okay, Sarah wants to add. Yes, Sarah. Okay, Sarah likes teddy bears. So Sarah keeps on buying teddy bears for her. Okay, that's great. Yes. Who else? Who is left? Yes, Vase. Where do you spend your money? Okay, Vase says that he loves playing games, so he keeps on buying different CDs and graphic cards for that. That's really great. Okay, classes, see? You do save money for yourself and then you spend it for useful purposes as well. Let's say instead of asking to somebody else for that, you spend your money for yourself. That's really great. Okay. So now what I want you is that look for the different ideas about how we can make money boxes for ourselves, because we will be making one for us. So I want you to search on it, to search on Google for that, and then bring some ideas for making money boxes, right? And then we will be making a money box together. Got it? Hope you guys enjoyed the lecture. I'll be seeing you in the next class. Take care. Allah Hafiz.